This is part two of graphing lines using the slope-intercept method. So as a reminder, these are the steps. We can only use the slope-intercept method if there is a y in the equation. And if there is, we will solve the equation for y to put in the form y equals mx plus b. We'll identify the slope, that'll be the m, and the y-intercept, remember that's the ordered pair 0b. Then we will plot the y-intercept. Next, we'll use the slope to find more points. Then we'll check a point on the graph to make sure it works in the original equation. So here's an example. Graph 2x minus 3y equals 6. The first thing I want to say is there are three methods of graphing. One is just plotting points. One is by using the x and y intercepts, and one is using the slope-intercept method. I'm going to go over how to do this particular problem using the slope-intercept method, but either of those other two methods works as well. All right, so our first step is to solve for y. So I need to get this 2x on the other side. So let's subtract 2x from both sides of the equation. That'll give me negative 3y equals, and remember we want to put the x term first, so I'm going to write negative 2x plus 6, because we're trying to get in the form y equals mx plus b. Next, we'll divide by the coefficient of y, which will be negative 3. And that gives me 2/3 y equals 2/3 x. Let's see. What's 6 divided by negative 3? Minus 2. So the slope is 2/3. And the y-intercept is going to be negative 2. So now we're going to plot the y-intercept and then use the slope to find more points. So we need to get a graph. Going down a little, I've got a graph here ready to bring up. Okay. So we've got to plot the y-intercept. So b is negative 2, so on the y-axis, we're going to go through the point 0, negative 2. And the slope is already written as a fraction. So it's positive over positive the way I've written it. So I'm going to go over 3 spaces and then up 2 spaces. And then I could do it again, go over 3 spaces and up 2 spaces. And then I've got to connect the dots with a line, and there I've got it. Now the last thing I want to do is a little checkpoint. So we have to remember what the original problem was. So let's slide back up here. What was it? 2x minus 3y is 6. 2x minus 3y equals 6. Let's do a little checkpoint. Well, it's going through the point 3, 0, isn't it? So I'm going to check this point and make sure 3, 0 really works in this equation. So that gives me 2 times 3 minus 3 times 0 equals 6. Is that correct? I'd have 6 minus 0 equals 6. Yep, it does check. So it looks like I've got it going through the right points. And we are done. By the way, you could have graphed this line by getting the x and y intercepts, and in fact, that's how I probably would have done this equation. Just keep in mind, that is another way to graph. Remember, first you put in 0 for x and figure out what y is. Then you put in 0 for y and figure out what x is. So when you put in 0 for x, you would get negative 3y equals 6. So y would have to be negative 2. And when you put in 0 for x, did I do that correct? Yes. When you put in 0 for x, when I put in 0 for y, saying it backwards, 2x is 6 tells you that x is 3. So notice I would have plotted the same two points you see here, 0, negative 2, and 3, 0. You would have gotten the same line. So you do have choices, but in this video, for the rest of them, I'm going to just go over it by doing slope-intercept method. Here's the next problem. Graph 5x minus 3y equals 9. Now it's true you can also do the x and y intercept method here, but you will get a fraction. for the x-intercept. So I'm going to do this using the slope-intercept method by solving for y. So I've got to subtract 5x from both sides. And then divide by negative 3. Which gives me y equals 5/3 x minus 3. So the slope is 5/3 and b is negative 3. Remember, we start off with a y-intercept. B is where it crosses the y-axis. So it crosses the y-axis at 0, negative 3. Now I'm going to use the slope to find another point. So the slope is 5/3, so I'm going to go over 3 to the right. They're both positive, and up 5. And I have a point right here. And if I do another point, I'm going to be a little bit off my graph. You could do this if you have bigger graph paper, but for now I'm going to go ahead and just graph that. So we have something like this. I hope you draw a straighter line if you have a straight edge. Okay, now let's make sure this point that we plotted right here really is on the original equation. Let's see, that's the point 3, 2. So let's just check 3, 2 in the equation. 5x minus 3y is 9. So we're putting in 3 for x, 2 for y, and seeing if this is true. 15 minus 6 equals 9. Yes. So all is well. Looks good. That's the equation of that line. I'm sorry. That's the graph of the line 5x minus 3y equals 9. If you would have done this by using the x and y intercepts, you would have gotten, by putting in 0 for y, that the x-intercept was 9/5, 1 4/5, and it does go through about 1 4/5. And if you put in 0 for x, you would have gotten the y-intercept at negative 3. So you should have gotten the same line using that method as well. How would you graph x equals negative 1? Think about that for a minute. Put this video on pause and graph that line. Hopefully you notice that there's no y term, which means you can't solve for y, so you can't put in slope-intercept form to use that method. So for this problem, graph x equals negative 1, we'd have to use some other method, which we've gone over, which is just always plotting points always works. So this is saying x is always negative 1, and so then we could pick any number we want for y. How about 0, 1, and 2? And then we could just plot those three points. Negative 1, 0, negative 1, 1, negative 1, 2, and then hopefully you recall that is the vertical line. So x equals negative 1 is the vertical line. Now I wonder why we couldn't put it in the slope-intercept form. Well, the vertical line, the slope is undefined. So in this vertical line, the slope is undefined. So that's one reason it was impossible to put in slope-intercept form. Also, where does it cross the y-axis? Nowhere. There is no y-intercept. So first, the slope's undefined. Second, there's no y-intercept. So there's a couple reasons why you could see you would have trouble trying to put it in slope-intercept form. How about y equals when? Do you remember how to graph that? You could go ahead and make a chart, just like we did in the previous problem. This is the way we did it when we first worked with these special cases. And y will always be when, so pick anything you want for x. How about 0, 1, and 2, and you could plot those points. But since this has a y in it, you can solve for y, and in fact it's already solved for y. And you could think of it as 0x plus 1. y equals 0x plus 1, so the slope is 0 and b is 1. You could use the slope-intercept method on this line, and you could state the slope and the y-intercept. So no matter how you look at it, you will get the same graph of the line, but in this case you can state the slope and the y-intercept. So if I plotted these three ordered pairs, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 2, and notice I'm going to get that horizontal line. But the other way you could have done this is by plotting the y-intercept at 0, 1, and then the slope, think of it as 0 over 1. You go over 1 and not up or down at all, over 1, not up or down at all. You get the exact same points. So I can graph this horizontal line using the slope-intercept method or by plotting points.